So my name is Kathleen Benjamin, and today we're going to be discussing tanning do's and don'ts. So first thing is, don't skip a patch test. You want to go in and to the tanning salon that you plan on going to and have them put a little patch on your elbow here or on your neck to see, make sure that you don't have an allergic reaction to it. Second don't is, don't go to a tanning bed. Tanning beds will increase the risk of skin damage. I recently just had a bride who went to a tanning bed, very fair, light skinned person, who went into a tanning bed and they put up the timing like way too high for her skin. And she got like second and third degree burns all over her chest and her back. And not only was she peeling on her wedding day, it was also very sensitive. That's not something you want to encounter on your wedding day. What they typically recommend is like 3 days, 2 to 3 days before your wedding is to go have the spray tan, right? Then go home, you have at least one shower before your wedding day to make sure that any excess rinses off. That way it won't transfer onto your dress, or if you start to sweat, you're not gonna see any streaks come up. Don't tan too close to the wedding day too. You don't wanna be, go like the day before and then not have enough time to shower that off, any of the excess. You wanna give it a day or two so that it can settle into your skin. The fourth don't is, you don't wanna overdo it either. You don't wanna go with something that's too dark for your skin tone, or that maybe potentially would look orange on your skin. That's why I highly recommend going, you know, a couple of months out from the wedding, maybe perhaps for your bachelorette party, trying it out. Make sure that you like the way it looks in photos, that you're happy with the color, that it's not transferring, and that your legs aren't streaking up. With the color all over your body and your chest, you're gonna have to make your face as dark so it doesn't look, you know, like you have two-toned skin. And when that happens, if you go too dark on the face, like it looks very muddy in photos and it almost doesn't even look like you. So make sure that you don't go too dark. And again, like I said, you can always, you know, try this out 1-2 months before the wedding. Make sure that you're happy with it. Take pictures of it. Go out to eat, do whatever, you know what I mean? See how it wears throughout the day. Take a shower, make sure you like it like the second or third day. It's all about knowing exactly what you're gonna be getting on that day. So let's move on to the do's. I think people think sometimes because they're getting a spray tan that they don't have to wear sunscreen, but you don't want to avoid wearing sunscreen either, because you will burn on top of that. And you just really want to keep the color nice and cohesive and having it look as natural as possible. So yeah, don't skip the sunblock. That's really important, especially on your face. So do moisturize, that's super important, and also exfoliate. Here are a few of the favorites that I like to use. So this is amylactin. It is a 12% lactic moisturizing lotion, and it actually, what it does, it's for rough, dry skin, but you know, your elbows, your knees, and your ankles, the backs of your arms, where the skin has a tendency to get rough and dry feeling, this will kind of remove that and lift that up off the skin. It'll just help regenerate new cell growth, and that's really what you want to do. Then I also go over it with one of these body brushes a couple times a week, just to kind of lift it off, remove it, and then put this lotion on top of it. And then to add in extra additional moisture, I use this one first. It's like a body serum. It's super light and moisturizing. Kind of put that all over. And then I use this eczema soothing relief cream, which happens to be a lot more inclusive and just a heavier type cream, which I have a tendency to use this more in the winter time than I do in the summertime, just because it's a little bit heavier. And when the air gets dry, you just want to kind of keep everything, the moisture locked in after you're showering. So these are some of my favorites. I also like to use, this here is the Tan Lux, the water. It's a hydrating self-tanning water. I just kind of spray that on after I'm done moisturizing and then let that dry onto my skin. I spray it on, then I just kind of rub it in with the moisturizer, and it kind of just gives me a healthier glow. It's not too heavy, it's not too dark, and I don't know, I really like the way that it looks. So again, do exfoliate, that's super important. You don't want that tanning to build up in those areas where the skin is dry and just harder and heavier looking. You wanna make sure that that's all removed so that the tanning, again, looks cohesive all over the entire body. And then my last do is to make sure that you do a trial run. Like I said, that's probably the most important thing out of all of these do's and don'ts, is go there, you know, do your research, talk to some other people that may have used different tanning places, and make sure that you're happy with the way that it looks, you're happy with the way that it feels on your skin, you're happy with the way that it wears for a couple days, because remember, you're also gonna be wearing this for your honeymoon too. So you wanna just make sure that it kind of holds up and it looks good throughout the duration of your wedding process. So anyway, that's it for me today. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, beauty is a celebration of self-expression and your uniqueness. So with that, thank you for watching. If you like this video, please consider subscribing, giving this video a thumbs up, and hitting that notification bell so you don't miss any upcoming videos.